What's good, everybody? It's Untold Insight, and I know I've been gone for a while. I haven't dropped any reviews on any herbs or anything lately. That's because I've been kind of busy doing other things, but I'm going to be more frequent now and start putting more videos up. Today we're going to review an herb, but before I get into that herb, I'm going to tell you another series that I'm going to be putting at the same time. I will be dropping something called the combination series, and that's pretty much going to be combinations on herbs that actually can benefit you in any type of way. Like yesterday I did an combination that I felt was very good, and if it was sold as an actual product, it would actually help a lot of people because it's a relaxant slash something, I guess you could say, to help you sleep really good. It pretty much, I mean, gave me and like pretty much put my whole body at ease. It eased my mind, and it helped me have such a nice full rest sleep, man. I haven't had a sleep like that in a while. So I will be experimenting more with that, and I will be putting combination videos up soon for you guys can try them for yourself. But like I said in other videos, man, anytime you guys deal with any type of herbs, I mean, be careful. Do your research about the herbs. Also, make sure that you're not allergic to some of these herbs, because there's some people that are actually just allergic to common herbs like chamomile, you know, because it has pollen and stuff like that. Some people get allergies because of this. So just make sure you do your research and stuff like that. Okay, now the herb I said I was going to review, I checked out YouTube, and there's a couple of people that put stuff up, but they don't put a lot of information up. They just pretty much just talk about the plant, and pretty much a lot of people are not actually talking about this. And this plant is pretty much in a lot of blends. You know, if people wanted to know, it's in a lot of relaxation blends and stuff like that, even smoke blends, because this herb can be smoked as well. It could be taken as a tea. And like I say, the way I take it, I prefer tincture form, because I feel that the properties, you can get them better through that form. You could do vegetable glycerin or alcohol-based tincture. I prefer alcohol because that's my preference. I just put the tincture in some juice, take it, and enjoy the properties and enjoy the effects. Now, the name of the herb is called skullcap, but it also goes by the name of mad dog weed. Now, this has a lot of medical uses for this. I'm going to tell you. One of the best is for helping breakaway addictions from people that are addicted to marijuana and also addicted to alcohol. This helps ease some of the, I guess you could say, feelings of wanting to still do those things. This is great for addictions. Okay, also it's great for arthritis. It's also great for attention deficit disorder. It's great for cancer. It's also great for coughs. It's also good for your cholesterol, your central nervous system. Okay, remember that one. It's also good for that. It's very great for depression, also for drug withdrawals. Like I've said before, it's good for fear. It's good for high blood pressure. It's also good for fatty livers. It's great for hangovers, headaches. Also good for heart palpitations. Insomnia, definitely this is great for insomnia. Also, something cool that I found out, it's also great for joints that are inflamed, you know what I'm saying, and they swelling. This is great for that. It's a liver stimulant. It's also a great lung cleanser. It's great for pain. They say that it's great for Parkinson's disease. I'm not too sure about that, but you know, there's some research out there that says that. It's good for poisonous bites, you know. It's great for rabies, they say. Restlessness, seizures. It's a sedative. It's also good for sleepiness, stress, strokes, and also thyroid problems. And it's known as a tranquilizer. So like I said, there's a lot more things that it's good for. So when you do your research, make sure you look at all these things. Like I said, some of these things are pretty much the better alternative. I prefer, if I can go all the way 100% natural on something that I would need, then I'll do it. Like for me, when it gets really bad something and I have to take medicine, like over-the-counter stuff, I'll take it. But if I could take care of it naturally, I'll go that route because I feel much better that way. And the rest of those chemicals that they add and fillers and stuff like that are not going to be in it. You know what I'm saying? You know what you're going to be doing because this is something you're preparing yourself. So if you make a tincture based just out of the skull cap, you know it's just going to be skull cap and just the alcohol in there. There's not going to be any fillers in there. You know, so like I say, and the way I take it, like I said, I take it in tincture form. When I take it, you don't really feel the effects that much, and you have to really pay attention to feel the effects, because some people, like I say, automatically they take herbs and the first thing they do is compare it to marijuana. Once again, people, like I'm going to keep on emphasizing, weed is its own plant. you'll never find something to duplicate it in the world because it's its own plant. Okay? The same way for anything else. Like, you won't find another skull cap somewhere else because skull cap is itself. You know, don't compare things. Go in there with an open mind, and that way you won't be let down, and that way you get to enjoy the properties. Like I said, if you're looking for a high, this is not it, man. Okay? I'm not trying to give reviews about stuff to get you high. Just stuff that are going to help you and stuff that'll, I guess, ease you in other ways and be useful to you or beneficial, you could say, in ways, in other ways in your life. Okay? The effects come on pretty much like 5 to 10 minutes after taking it for me. It might be different for everybody else. And they're pretty nice. You start feeling your body, I guess, loosen up. If you have a lot of tension, it'll start loosening. Your mind will start slowing down. Pretty much is overall good. Like I said, I use this for pain as well. So when you have pain, you'll notice it decrease. You know, in combinations, like I said, just to throw this out there, it's great with willow bark as a nice ultimate pain relieving. You know, if you mix this with some willow bark tincture, it actually increases because willow bark is also for pain. But like I said, I'll get into that herb in another series, and I'll get into the combinations. Like I said in earlier in this video, I'll get into that in other series as well. But like I said, I haven't seen a lot of people talk about the skull cap, and I feel this is something that should be good. And like I said, you could take it as a tea, which I'm not fond of because I don't like so much how teas taste and stuff like that. And smoking it, if I was a smoker, I probably would smoke it, but I don't smoke anymore, so I take it in my tincture form. Like I said, I feel that's the best way to do it. So, you know, guys, if you guys come across this herb and you want something, like I said, for any one of these things, I use this preferably for relaxation and just pain in general. Those are the two reasons why I use skullcap. And sometimes I use them by themselves, and sometimes I use it in combinations, like I will show in later videos. So, you guys got any questions about anything, or would you like me to talk about another herb? Send me a message on YouTube. I'll get back to it as soon as possible. I don't check it every day, so give me some time when I do check it, because I am, like I said, I do other things as well. So when I see it, I'll get back to it. And you know, till we get to the next review, everybody, you know what I'm saying? Stay in sight.